with no internal traction control in Assetto, and you have to do it quite. It's quite hard to get it working, but we'll figure it out. So first thing you do, you just download the zip I made like just today, and it's not password protected. I will show you that it's just free to download. You just download it anywhere you want. For example, yeah. Then you open it, and you will have to install it. You have to just copy this glove by folder somewhere, like I've copied in all my program files. Here, I have the same thing, plus minus some other just profiles for it, but it shouldn't mind. And then you have to install the PPJoy driver. Here's the tricky part, that you have to actually, on newer Windows, you have to disable driver signature enforcement, which I'll post the link how to do it somewhere, because it's really hard to record. And but it should be like, after you disable it, you will have this small testing mode notification here on your desktop, and so you'll be good to go. And then, wait, I will just remove it for you. And then what you'll have to do is, after installing the PPJoy driver, just search for in start menu or anywhere where you want for configure, and you have this configure joysticks for PPJoy, and there you have to add one. Just set to virtual joystick, control one, and then just check mapping. I don't think it's necessary, but you can change how many axes you want to use and how many buttons you have to use. And so you can re-personalize it later, but you can use the default settings for what we want to do. Then press done, and it's almost pretty much it. Then you just run GlovePy, and then you open your I will just extract one thing we had. We need you extract all of this, but this is the program I've written, the mouse drive PI. You just open it with your glove PI, and so here's the code. There are some little things, but I guess the most important part is here. Here you can set your linearity for your steering wheel, and here you can set the sensitivity. Here you can test your input, because the thing what this program does is that it tracks your mouse input, and then it sends to PPJoy joystick, and then the PPJoy joystick is read by Assetto Corsa, and you have like joystick there or steering wheel. So here are the presets. There's if you press keyboard A, then it does upshift. You can check it by pressing the run button, and here you can see that if I press A, then variable upshift, which is that you actually upshift in Assetto, is active. And there's downshift, and there's clutch, and there's handbrake, and there's gas and brake, which are exit, but we'll figure that later. And here's the mouse steering. You can plug the values just to get it just to get you comfortable with it. So the last thing we need to do is just go in Assetto Corsa and configure the joystick for the game. So now there's one tricky part again. You go to options, and you go to controls, And here you have to assign your axis to your gamepad. You have to run the glove pie again, and here you see that there are two axes for gas and brake, button for upshift, downshift, clutches are also an axis, handbrake is just button, and there you can configure like look left, look right, or back view, or any button you. It's all written here that you have here. There are left view, right view, view behind. You just can configure it for yourself. But so you assign to here we have just one continuous axis, like the steering axis, which is I guess it's this one. Yeah. These two bar mouse. So what do you have to do? It's just you can keep it for steering and click to assign and assign the steering. Now you see that your steering axis is attached to a mouse, but to assign throttle it won't work just with clicking because it's just too fast for us to calibrate it. So you have to do the tricky thing that you rewrite the gas variable with mouse just for a while. So and you have to turn the mouse steering off, and I guess it's it's this one. You just put these two slashes there, so it's like ignored my program. And so now you see that just made another axis moving. So I'll attach it to throttle. And then I'll do the same for. Wrong thing. I just set it back to gas. And I'll do it for brake. So now you see the different axis moves. So I'll do just for a break, and we'll do it one more time for clutch. You can rename these variables because the thing that what this program does is that you press your, like for example, clutch. So there's, if the keyboard X is pressed, then it changes the variable clutch to 1, else it changes to -1. So you can change this clutch for, I don't know, you can just write here C and there's C, and you can write here C and it will work, but I think it's nicer to have the full name of it. So now we should have configured the most important things. So you see now the throttle goes all the way up when I press left mouse button, and all the way down if I release it. Same with brakes, same with clutch. And now we have to just do the shifters. Gear shift up, I'll do just for mouse button 1, gear shift down button 2. You can use advanced just for maybe glance left, use like button 4, grand side for 5. Oh, I don't have button for this, so. Now we can go to Assetto. Just for example, just select the random car and just go to. Turn on the mouse steering and save the file. Just to have it set just for forever. And here's the tricky thing. Here there's toggle to switch off the mouse movement. So just when you press the console button, your mouse stops moving around, but the steering wheel works still. So now we have steering wheel, we have brake, we have gas, we have clutch, And the most important thing is that when you go and start skidding around, your throttle doesn't lift up, so you can just really drift easily without losing power when in oversteer. So now you can properly drift on way more underpowered cars, so you don't have to have like 500 horsepower just to slide around corners. For instance, this car has somewhere around 250, and it can slide pretty well. So thanks for watching, and see you later in the next video.